Okay, today we're going to be taking podcast notes from the forest. So here on my screen, you can see this top link here under podcast. This is what it's going to look like after we're done. If I click on this, you can see it's got a couple tags, one for podcast, one for Readwise. It's got the URL from Snipd, which I'm going to go into in a second. It's got the author, which is just the podcast name, this one called AI and I. And it's got the highlights that I saved from within the Snipd app. So this workflow is going to take the actual podcast notes from Snipd. Now, Snipd is a paid app, but you can use it for free pretty extensively. I think you can do like 2 podcasts a week on it or something. So you can use it for free if you're a light user, but it's not that expensive, even if you're a heavy user like I am. So this is a really cool app. I'm going to show it to you in a second because that's going to be step one. But I first wanted to show you just how, you know, it lands on your notes. It's really nice. I think that was yesterday. Yep, it kind of organizes it into everything. And by the way, I'm going to be doing a series on how to save everything from like books, audiobooks, articles, all that good stuff. So keep an eye out for that. But first, we are going to set up an account with Snipd. So that is an app. I will meet you over there. Okay, so this is what Snipd looks like. It's a really cool app. Again, I use it mainly for podcasts, and I just found out they have an Apple Watch and stuff. So this is not going to be a great Snipd demo because I'm fairly new to it, and I'm just going to be using basic functionality. But basically what I've done is I've gone into this podcast, AI and I, that I listen to, their new episode with Steph Smith. It's a great episode, by the way. I love this podcast. And I actually just kind of did some AI-generated ones. So that's like, you know, it gives the show notes, the AI-generated summary, the chapters, and all that stuff. But there's features where you can take your own notes. You can do, I think it's like a triple tap or something from your headphones so that you can just be walking around and start taking podcast notes and save things. So I just want to give like the preface that this is not a good Snipd demo. It's a really powerful app with a lot to it. I'm going to assume that you're going to play with that on your own and just assume that we already have some notes in Snipd recorded. So if you haven't, sign up for Snipd and save some notes. And then we're going to go over to the profile page. If I tap on my profile on the bottom right here, it brings up this, oops, let me go back. I think it brings up this page here. And then you're going to want to go to export and sync. And you're going to click on Readwise integration. And you can see there they have a couple others there too, but I'm going to be focusing on Readwise. Now, Readwise is another app. Sorry, this workflow involves 2 apps, but I mean, if you're a regular podcast taker, I don't know. I feel like it's worth paying a couple dollars a month to take podcast notes. But Readwise is an app that directly integrates with Reflect. So that will automate all of this. And Readwise does a ton of stuff too, by the way. Like you can sync your Kindle books there. You can sync, you know, like video notes. I think audiobook notes. So I might be doing one on audiobooks there. Lots of stuff in Readwise. Super, super cool app. There's a reason it's one of the only apps we have an integration for it. But we're going to turn this on. And you can see here that we're going to need a Readwise access token. But thankfully, they have this really handy link that just kind of does everything for you. So I'm going to click on this link, and it's going to open up the page within Readwise where I can get my access token. So this will, of course, require you having a Readwise account. They have a free trial, so you can check it out if you want. And it's pretty affordable after that, too. So click on Get Access Token. I'm not going to show you getting mine because I don't want to have to change it, and I don't want everyone using my access token. So just click on that link and it will walk you through the process. So I'm going to do that kind of off screen and then I'll come back. And again, I won't be able to show you, but when I'm done, basically right here where I can just kind of type in anything, it will automatically pull in my Readwise access token. But again, I can't show you that part because it would give away my access token publicly. So I'm going to go get it. It's going to paste here and then we are going to go back into Readwise. But one last thing I want to mention before I do that, there's of course some options here. These are all up to you, what you want to do. I had it done everything, but I didn't want it to only sync the edited and tagged notes. So, you know, that's your preference. So I will meet you back in, where will I meet you back? Readwise, I guess. Yeah, I'll meet you back in Readwise and we'll make sure that the sync is working correctly. Okay, so I'm back here in Readwise on desktop just because it's a bit easier to show. This is just the dashboard page. And so I'm gonna go to export and you're gonna need to configure it with Reflect. So, you know, you just click on that and do it if you haven't already. And then click on the Reflect export option. And it brings you to this page where, you know, you can see everything that Readwise has pulled in. And so on the top here, I see the podcast that I was doing within Snipd. And so, you know, make sure you have the right grass name. I have a lot because of the demo videos, but a lot of you probably only have one. If you have multiple, make sure you have the right one. You can choose to do it automatically. I would highly recommend to turn it on automatically. I do. And that means when you just take new podcast notes, they will sync and save automatically, which is great. And select items. If you're doing this initially, you might want to select items to be exported and then do them all at once. Start the export there. Mine probably won't have any new ones. Yeah, because it's automatically set up. So I already did them automatically. But if you're doing that for the first time, it will show up there either as the new note synced or the highlight. And then if I go back into my Reflect notes, again, this is what it looks like from within Reflect. And I just want to emphasize, like, the daily note organization here is really, really nice. I had saved this yesterday, and it's just wonderful that it kind of organizes everything like this and makes it the perfect way to save things. So I'm really, really excited about this. If you know, are a big podcast listener, definitely give this a try. It's amazing to take good notes off of podcasts. And if you made it this far in the video, I always forget to say this, please subscribe to our channel and check out some of our other videos and share them with our friends. We also have new weekly note-taking workflows, and I'll put a subscribe link in the description of the video. So hope you enjoy it.